is in the wrong way. That man is in the wrong way.
But we're building Milton Keynes to bring next year, so we thought that would be an absolute unique ring station for the venue.
You're actually going to build Milton Keynes?
Yeah,
railway.
We spent all day on Friday measuring the station and taking pictures. So next year we'll bring Milton Keynes itself.
To Milton Keynes.
Yeah, to Milton Keynes. Brilliant, huge, wasn't it? Milton Keynes at Milton Keynes.
Oh, fantastic. We'll have to come back next year. And what is it about Milton Keynes and this particular show that brings you back?
Well, I go through Milton Keynes three times a week on the train. And it's just an amazing station because of all the buildings. So when you look at the whole of Britain as a modeler, you go, where's the most modern looking place? And it's Milton Keynes. Because of those buildings, you've got the new car park and all those buildings that reflect the light. So it's a pretty unique station for a modeler.
And can you sum up what is it about trains? I mean, it's your first love, isn't it? Straight out of school, onto the railway.
Yeah. Camaraderie. Everybody in here's got one thing in common. They'll all talk to each other. They don't walk around and not talk to people. That's what this hobby is. It's about sharing your knowledge and talking to people that are as passionate as you are about the subject.
And lots of people come and talk to you. You must have all sorts of conversations. What do you chat to people about?
Anything and everything. Somebody's always got a story. You know, you put that in there and somebody comes in and says, well, actually, I spoke to the guy and he knows different.
Do you get tips off other people? I mean, it sounds you share. How does that work?
Oh, no. I mean, you come to these shows, you see something and you think, how did you do that? You say, and then you go back and you change your style in that way. That's why we bring this, you know. We built this for the Chester Cathedral. And that's about getting young people to play with trains and enjoy themselves. When we come here, you're working to a different audience, because these are already railway enthusiasts. So here it's about picking up other tips and seeing what's new and what we can use.
And am I right in thinking you've got the longest track? Tell us a little bit about this track this year.
Well, this is 64 feet, just in one straight line, so there's 130 feet of railway. It's between Rugby and Killsby, which is in Northamptonshire. That's why I'm building Milton Keynes, because we can stick it on the end of this and we can get to 158 feet, which will be the biggest model railway in the world.
And how long did that take? I'm guessing you had to
six months. We only get 6 months. We literally get the dean confirmed that we're in, and we have to be in by the first week of July. So we get literally 6 months. You can't do it 5 days a week. You can only do a couple of days a week.
Crikey. How does it feel to be able to show it off then, knowing it's going to be even bigger next year?
Yeah, great. It's...
That's
explained by your ear then.
Yeah, it was easier rather than potentially packing the clothes through the eye.
Thank you.
good. You failed looking at me there.
Looking back at this one.
That's lovely. Hands off.
There's seven cats already going around the vehicles on display. This is the sort of marching area.
Yes.
And it's the Royal Mail.
Down slow.
I mean, actually, when you see in a place like this, it looks quite small.
At least I didn't get people doing that, like looking at me and smiling. Yeah.
Building the layout 55-15 out of the dirt.
Okay, yeah.
Would one of those, because I need at least 5 amps.
Yeah, so when I had my own gate garden, I had the same gate garden property, but I used an 8 amp.
An 8 amp?
Yeah, we only do an 8 amp.
Oh, right.
You will need a booster, 4.5 amp or 3.5 amp.
Yeah, because I was talking to somebody at Stafford the other day, and they were saying, I need 2. Because what I'm doing is I'm building Manson Connery to the top of the
refrigerator.
So I'll need one at either end, and then I'll take it for one
run round. You've got to build it up in layers, so you let each layer dry. And avoid using PVA glue underneath it because it reacts with the resin. Yeah, find out somewhere.
I've only just started building like my track.
Yes.
How do you get the sound to work? And they call this on the sound. I'll say that.
Do your trains have sound in them?
Yes. I think one of them does. Yeah.
So if one of them does, if you have a digital controller, yes. It's usually function one that turns the sound on and off for anything.
Right. I think I got, what happened was I bought the train second hand, and I don't think it's going to be digital control.
There's a few standard features on most controllers, so whatever it is, if it's got lights. This.
When it does.
I don't know if you remember my little 04 shunt, it was always stopping and starting. And yet once I did it for iTrain, it works lovely now. You saw it and I think you could watch it.
Okay.
There it goes.
Some comments quite nice on my channel. Thank you. I said to I saw Charlie Bishop.
Oh,
seen him. Yeah, I've seen him.
Hello. There's no figures, there's no farmer, is
Most of them I never used to do because I used to be at school, but now I'm left. It's alright. Yeah. I don't start work until November, so I've got, you know, much free time to do whatever, really.
Fantastic. I might ask your dad if he might ask me that on camera. That's
not good. I know what you are.
So it's the fact that you've done it along with your dad, but it's the first one you've been able to come to.
Ask
him
whatever you want.
Yeah. Are you not dad?
He's horrified. He's horrified.
No, now I feel like I've offended someone. So your dad...
That's the best thing to tell you about
one weekend. So your father and son, and you do it together?
Yes.
Where are you from? Somerset. Can I get a little shot of you working together? If you're happy for me to film yourself, it'd just be nice to say, you know, and now he's finished school.
Two bucks!
This is probably my favourite.
Yep. Have night and day.
Yeah. It's all the way down.
That's a classic LGBT.
Yeah, and the yellow frame. And then we've just added to it as.
So who's doing it now?
Yeah.
Where is that?
Where is that?
There is, but they were bought by Markman.
Right, right. Yeah, yeah.
And they've gone very. They doubled the price over there. And they've gone very serious.
I knew they'd reach
it. Yeah, that's true. Sometimes we need the layer, it's back to back, it's not yet.
Had it to do. I'd be lucky if it.
Oh, they're too close, are they?
No, it's just a fucking
sliced
drum and
we're going to move it. Yeah, on the near the line, at least.
The only thing I don't.
That's it, Dan. You can hold it there, keep going, keep going. That there.
Right. Yeah, they tried doing that on Buck's Lane at Macclesfield, and I said, no, we're not doing it.
Let me know when you've got the two car up and running.
Thank you. Thank you. You